What is going on, everybody? I am Mike. Welcome back to Tech 24/7 TV. I'm so glad that you are back with me today because we are talking about focus modes, how to get laser-like focus with your iPhone, with your iPad, with your Apple Watch. We all want to be more present. We all want to be less distracted, and we want to get some serious work done and maybe even have some fun while we're at it. Well, you are in the right place because focus modes are going to help you out. Let's get started. Now, in today's video, we're going to talk about what focus modes are, how to use them, how to customize them, how I'm using them, as well as some pro tips that I'm going to sprinkle on throughout the video. Now, before we get in the video, YouTube tells me that 90% of you that are watching this video, yes, you, are not subscribed to the channel. Now, that is a shame because I like making videos just like this, focusing on productivity, the iPad, the iPhone, and I know you don't want to miss my iOS and iPadOS 15 review when it comes out this fall. So go ahead and click that subscribe button, turn on notifications, because you don't want to miss that video. Now, the video itself is going to be broken down into different sections, and I'm going to have each one of those sections pinned down in the first comment below with appropriate timestamps. That's going to be in case you want to revisit a section, if you want to share a section with someone who might find it useful, it's going to be a lot easier. Also, I'm going to be working on my iPad, so if you want to get your iPad or your iPhone, whatever the case is, and we can do this together, be my guest. First and foremost, Apple's introducing focus modes, which are a set of tools really to allow you to be more mindful, more present, and less distracted when you are interacting with your iPhone, your iPad, your Apple Watch, and your Mac. Focus modes are a contextual-based way of aligning your intentions with your device. This allows you to set up your device and configure in such a way to allow only the important people and apps to send you notifications when you want them, allowing you really to set time aside to focus on whatever's important to you in that given moment. Focus modes can help you be more productive, more present, more connected, less interrupted, allow you to do your best work and enjoy your downtime without necessarily getting into the weeds of all the different apps, all the different notifications, unless you want to. You are now in control. Whether you are in the car, using your favorite app, or connecting an accessory to your device, context matters when it comes to iOS and iPadOS 15 with focus modes. Context is what is going to power and accelerate you and your focus modes to do the best work that you can do. For example, I have time-based context, I have location-based context, and I have triggers on my device that tell my device what I'm going to be doing. They're sending signals to my device saying which focus mode that it should put itself into. For example, you can have time-based context that turn on your focus mode every day at a certain time. You can have a location-based context that anytime that you come into this location, you need to turn on a certain focus mode. Or anytime that you connect your favorite accessory or peripheral to your device, that is also be seen as a signal or as a trigger to enable focus mode, which makes it very powerful and completely customizable. Now we've talked about what focus modes are and how they work. Let's go ahead and take all that knowledge and let's set up our iPad with some focus modes that we learned. Now, first things first here is that if you want to access focus modes, you can simply pull down from the control center and tap here and you see your list of focus modes. Now here you see the entire list, which includes the ones that I have. You could see here that we have do not disturb, personal, work, sleep, gaming, and fitness. Those are all default focus modes. I added filming, planning, and then I also customized gaming a little bit as well. Now let's go ahead and we're going to click on filming so we get no notifications while we're doing this video. If I wanted to, I'm going to go ahead and set this up fresh. I'm going to go to settings. In the second card here in settings, near the bottom is going to be focus. Click on focus. And then here it shows that same list of focus modes. Now, if I wanted to, I could add one by clicking on the plus button in the top right-hand corner, and I have the ability to choose custom, mindfulness, or reading. Now, focus modes can be shared across your devices if you want them to. Now let's look at the gaming focus mode, because this is the one that I have that's pretty customized. First here is the only person that can send me notifications is going to be my wife, which is identified here, and that will only come through inside of the Messages app. I do allow my iPad, my iPhone to send me time-sensitive notifications, so if something is urgent, like I have a calendar alert or someone's at my doorbell, I will get that alerted on my phone. The focus state here, this is a message that is displayed to any individual that has iOS 15 installed on their device. It'll let them know I'm away, and it'll give them the option where if they want to break through my focus and still send me a message. You can go ahead and hide home screen notifications in addition to hiding certain home screens. Now, when I activate the gaming focus mode, I only see one or two different home screens, which is available. and I'll show it with you in a second. Then on the lock screen, you can dim the lock screen in addition to showing silence notifications on the lock screen. Gaming is set up where if you connect a wireless controller, it will automatically switch to gaming focus mode. So now here, I'm gonna turn on my wireless controller, my Sony PS5, and it's gonna pair with my device, and we should see here the focus mode change. There it goes. Now, if I go back to my home screen, now there you see my gaming home screen, which is a mix of different widgets and different apps that I have available, and there's nothing else. Now, as soon as I disconnect this from my iPad, it should revert back to the previous mode that it was in. And also, what's one thing is really interesting is if I hit the PlayStation button on the controller, it'll automatically open up my games folder to pull up games. So that's actually kind of a nice feature. Let's go ahead and power this off. And then you see there, it automatically switched back over to my filming focus mode. Now, let's say I want to get real nerdy and I want to customize my focus mode a little bit more here. Well, you can build shortcuts on top of your focus mode. So now let's say here I have my shortcuts widget here and I have game mode. Anytime I click on my focus mode, it's going to go ahead and enable that focus mode shortcut, and it's going to change my wallpaper. Now, if I wanted to, I could actually even change any number of kind of system configurations. I could change things like screen brightness, my display lock, any number of things that are really kind of helpful. If I were to go back, let's say I'm going to say go back home, and it does the same thing. It does take a few seconds longer than I would hope to change the wallpaper, but it's actually not really bad. If I click on planning, it shows again a limited number of home screens, and all of it can be configured inside of the shortcut menu for that focus mode. Now let's go ahead and walk through that right now. Here I have created a folder called focus for my focus modes, and this is where I'm going to place all of my focus mode related shortcuts in. And the reason being because when I have a widget on the home screen, I want to be able to call to a certain menu. Now I have four different shortcuts here. I have go home, game mode, planning, and filming. Let's just take a look at game mode here. So game mode here, I says turn gaming on until it's turned off. We're going to go ahead and find a photo album, which is called gaming, which I've created. And then I'm going to set that wallpaper to that. So what I'm doing here is I'm actually adding another rule, say running display lock. So let's try this here. I'm going to go down to my home screen, and you see here I have some planning shortcuts. I'm going to add my widget just to show you what that looks like. Okay, edit widget, folder, focus. Boom. All right, so that's set up. I'm going to click on go back home. It changes my home screen. You see that? It changes my widgets. That's all complete. Now here I have the widgets on there. I'm going to say go to gaming mode. And you see it's changing the home screen widgets. And now you see it brings up the auto lock, which is kind of useful. For me, at least, when I'm filming, that's usually where I have the display auto lock preference configured, where if I want to not have my screen shut off because maybe I'm filming my iPad and I don't want to mess with any of that, I have that turned on. And so you could re-add that rule. It's very, very simple, but let's take a look at another one. So I click on planning and it limits the screens that I have. So I have some screens related to productivity, some my task management, and you see it changed my wallpaper. If I click go back home, it changes right back to it. So it's actually very easy to do. It's straightforward enough where I think the average person can go ahead and do so. Now I'll copy links to my shortcuts in case you want to use them and put them down in the video description so you can use them as starting points. There's nothing sensitive in there, so it's your choice. Otherwise you can just follow the instructions that I just went through. Now for me, I can say that focus modes has really been enabling where I've been able to kind of switch context almost effortlessly from heads down mode to maybe lean back mode playing a game. And that's because it really removes the distractions, and that helps me as someone who typically has a hard time managing distractions. So I could tell you that, again, in my own experience, focus mode is very powerful. If you found something useful in this video, let me know down in the comments below. Otherwise, I will see you in the next video. My name is, oh, you know what? Hold on one second. I forgot about this. If you've made it this far, you are already into it. This is the Cover Buddy sleeve for the 12.9-inch iPad Pro 2021 specifically. Let me know in the comments below if you want to see this reviewed. They just sent this to me. I don't know, kind of mixed feelings on this one. Let me know down in the comments below. My name is Mike. Hope to see you in the next video. Folks, I will talk to you in the next one.
Activate my focus mode.
Okay, which room?
Set my focus mode.
What mode did you want to set?
Personal.
Here's what I found.
Set my focus mode.
What mode did you want to set?
Change my focus mode.
What mode did you want to set?
Filming.
Done.